This is how you can stay ahead of competition with data-driven A/B testing even before you go to the market with your ads. In this video, I'll show you how I compare three different ads and choose the best performing one to make data-driven decisions before I go to market with the ad. I'll look at scores and heat maps to make these decisions, and I'll use a tool called Predict to do that. Let's get to it. I'm now inside the folder where I will upload the ads to. I'll just drag and drop my ads in here, but you can also click this upload button to upload your ads. Right now the platform is predicting my images so I can get the results. The ads are now ready and I'll click into one of them. On the left side here you can see the toolbar where there's a few different options of heat maps, and they're actually connected to the scores down here. I'm not going to go too much in depth with the scores today because I'm going to focus more on the heat maps and the AOIs that we're going to create in a minute. But first we need to understand how heat map works. Thomas, can you help me explain how the heat maps are generated?
Sure, I'll be happy to. When you're looking at a heat map, it does have several colors. As you can see, it goes from green to yellow to red. The red and the warmer colors mean that these are the areas that people are more likely to pay attention to, while the areas that are green or have no colors are the areas that people are less likely or not likely to pay attention to at all. The heat map represents the prediction of attention. But what we have done is to make sure that that prediction is 95% accurate compared to eye tracking collected data. But we are also constantly adding new data to this database. So every month we are adding more and more people using eye tracking, EEG, and other implicit measures to understand and measure and collect data on consumer responses. This allows us to keep the models up to date. So that means that when you are doing a prediction, you're not using an older model. You're constantly using a model that is up to date in terms of consumer responses and also the latest trends in marketing and design. Back to you, Amber.
Thank you, Thomas. So now that we understand how the heat maps are generated, we can now look more into the AOIs. With AOIs, which is areas of interest, you can measure the performance of any element in your creative assets. I'm gonna choose the rectangle tool to draw around the logo. We can see here that the logo gets 4.8% of the overall attention on the ad. I will also draw around the message and do the same on the other ads, or you can simply copy paste the AOIs. I've now drawn all the AOIs on all the ads and we're now ready to compare them. So next I'll click the button called Compare and click the two other ads. Here we can see the compare view where we have the three different ads and we can see the AOIs that are drawn on the image. Overall, we can see that the third ad scores a lot higher on the AOI scores, and we can see that the logo gets a higher attention score. This means that people are more likely to remember the brand than on the other ads. The message also has a higher attention. Lastly, we can also see that the CTA button gets more attention, which means that there will be a higher chance that people will click your ad. We can see that ad number 3 is the best performing ad, and this would be the ad that we would go to market with. If your goal is to create more brand recognition overall, I would put a lot more focus on the brand and the logo. In our case, the third ad was the winner because we wanted more attention to all of the elements on the ad, but it of course depends on where you want the attention to go on your ads. Thank you for watching.